interested in if they have anything or if they want to write anything that's about any of those kinds of topics or about silver or anniversaries or whatever, send it to me and it could go into that issue because I'm still collecting stuff for it. Or about Me Too stuff because I have a section of somebody's poems that I'm like, there's going to be a special section in this issue. So I have to give that invitation. If anybody wants to send anything like that, they can email it to me and I can forward it and blah, blah, blah. And I'm done talking about that. I'm going to St. James Bones now. I lost my breath. Big three randomly here for you. This one is the beginning of the book, When You Dream Tonight. And it is called Dreams 122208, The Indescribable Infant. I don't know if I was sitting on a bed or not, but I was near a sink and there was a small animal of some sort laying on a plastic carved sheet. I don't know, it could be no longer than my hand, but it was laying there like it was a newborn. And the only thing I could think to do was clean it, like it was a newborn that needed to be cleaned. So I ran water in the sink until it was a tepid temperature, and I thought that this animal, I don't know what it was, it looked like it had more human-like head, but I can't remember legs on it, and I couldn't tell you the sex of the creature. But I brought this indescribable infant and this curved plastic sheet to the sink to just run a little bit of water to clean off this the front to the back. So well, I saw what looked like could have been a fecal matter, and I washed off it with the water, and so I ran a little more water again and did this a few more times until I apparently ran enough to make the indescribable infant start to slide down that curved plastic sheet. I started to sit up right after it slid, and I could see a look on its face, and it was about to cry. It almost seemed like a human cry, but I think there were no legs, and I looked panicked, and I was trying to deal with this indescribable infant as it stared at me, whimpering, as it started to whimper, about to cry. So I instinctively picked it up, and it still wasn't clean, but I didn't care, and I tried to put it against my chest to help this indescribable infant to make it feel better in the new world.
Wow.
And as I was dressing today, I was like, I don't know what to wear, and I had plaid shorts and a gray shirt, and I'm looking through, and I'm like, wait, I've got a curtain shirt that says camping on it. I guess that would relate to dreams or something. I'll put that on, and I had to change it. Change it again, sorry. This one's from that same He Told Me His Dreams series. He Told Me His Dreams 7. When I was little, I would have dreams where I found riches. A large, rare, expensive gold coin, a pile of money hidden into a cave. And the one thing I remember most is that I always wanted to take it back with me. I knew I was dreaming, and I would think, God, please, I just want to wake up and have this gold coin when I wake up. And I would try to hold the treasure firmly in my hand, wake myself up only to find a tightly clenched fist. Once I even remember putting a wealth under my pillow in my dream, and then I would wake up. My instinct told me to turn over my pillow as soon as I could. There was never anything there. Dream is 09-1706. Dad talking to me. This is the strangest dream I've ever had, because it was like Dad was talking around and he was walking and talking to me about my night's sleep and, oddly enough, my drinking. Now, my dad drinks a lot more than me, so this is why him asking about this seemed odd, because he came to me and said, "You've been drinking a lot." And I was taken off a bit by his statement, so I answered, "Well, you can understand why." And he seemed to agree to understand that I drink more because Mom just died. Now, I usually ask him how he slept while I'm in town now, not only because Mom has just died, but also because he has had trouble breathing. But this time, Dad asks me first about how I slept, and I told him the truth, that I had had a hard time falling asleep because I was crying, thinking about Mom. Then I even said that I called John, my husband, because I knew he'd be up. It was only 10:40 at home, so I could call him and he'd be awake. So I called him to make me feel better. And I felt bad bringing it up to Dad, since he can cry at the drop of a hat when Mom is brought up. But it was the first time I had mentioned my feeling bad about Mom's death to Dad. And yeah, you'd have to know that I'd never mentioned this to my dad. So when I woke up this morning, everything was the same as usual. Dad drank his swig from his whiskey bottle and asked me to go for a cart ride with him over to the hut to have beer at 10 in the morning. So yeah, this had to be a dream.
I found the poem about being a tourist.
Yay!